Hello friends, I am Harivir Singh, subject matter expert at the Gate Academy. Today we are going to learn something about motion curve, specifically velocity versus time. So let us have a look at three equations of motion which we are having. Like velocity we define as time rate of change of displacement. In the same manner, acceleration we define as time rate of change of velocity. And clubbing these two equations we will get ads is equals to v dv. So out of this, all three equations are very useful, but specifically these equations, if they are to be represented in graphical form, then how to represent. So let us take example of a graph between velocity and time, now where velocity is in meter per second and time is in second. Now, any curve can be any curve like this. So, let us take at time t equal to t1, this is initial velocity is equals to u. Then, some other time t equal to t2, this is some other velocity, v final is equals to v. So this actually represent, this line is actually representing velocity versus time. If we know the position of, if we know the velocity of any object at different distances of time and we are plotting them, then we are getting this curve. Now this curve is very useful in terms of so many pieces of information are there. With respect to time, we already know the velocity, but other parameters like what is the displacement covered by the body, what is the acceleration of the body at any instant of time, we can predict by looking at this diagram only. So for that, suppose if we take area under the curve, area under the curve from t1 to t2, we are talking about this area. So how to take that? So let us take some vertical elemental area for the time span of dt. This is dt, very small time interval. At that time, it is some velocity, and this velocity is actually given as a function of time, because we know velocity at any instant of time. This velocity is function of time. So area under the curve will be equals to nothing but integral of velocity multiplied by dt. So now look at this first equation of motion. If we write velocity times dt, that is equals to ds. So from this equation we can put here, we'll get area under the curve is equals to nothing but our displacement. What is the limit for displacement? Initial displacement to final displacement. That is mean between the given time limits from t1 to t2, how much displacement body will cover, that displacement we can easily identify by calculating area under the curve. So area under the curve will tell you the displacement. What is the displacement of the body? S final minus S initial. Area under the curve. This is very important observation. And at the same time, if we calculate slope of the curve. So slope of the curve is nothing but this height is v, this height is t. So slope of the curve easily we can calculate by dv over dt. And if you look at our second equation, so dv over dt directly giving you the value of acceleration. So slope of the curve is nothing but the acceleration at that instant. This is the tangent actually. The slope of the curve dv over dt is actually tangent. At any point you can draw tangent, and at that point you find at that instant of time how much your acceleration is. Tangent you need to find and then put the value of time, you will get the acceleration at that point. That is nothing but slope of the curve. Now, Gate, they have asked one problem based on this motion curve. So we will discuss one problem from Gate exam 2016. कितने सेकंड तक का है? छः है ना।
एक पे एक, दो पे एक,
दो पे भी,
तीन पे चार, तीन पे चार, सीधे पांच पे बनाना, पांच पे दो,
पांच पे दो,
बस छः पे जीरो,
छः पे जीरो जा रहा है, दो के बाद ये ऊपर गया, ये पांच पे जीरो से स्टार्ट हुआ है ना,
तीन
ठीक है, The following figure shows the velocity time plot for a particle traveling along a straight line. The distance covered by the particle from t equal to 0 to t equal to 5 seconds is in meter. Now, please have a look over the problem. Whatever data is given, they have asked the distance. Be careful about this. They have asked the distance, not the displacement. Because displacement and distance can be different also. So first we have to check whether the particle velocity is any point of time is becoming negative or not. So by looking at the curve, velocity is always positive. It's nowhere it being negative. So that means particle which is moving in straight line, it is always moving along a straight line. It is not coming back. If it is coming back, velocity at any point it would have been negative, then distance and displacement we have to calculate separately. But in our case, as velocity is not becoming negative, distance will be equals to displacement. Because velocity is always positive. So this is the case we got from here. Now displacement, how to calculate? Displacement we can calculate by calculating first from t equal to 0 to t equal to 5. So we have to calculate area under the curve on velocity time plot. So that's what we need to calculate now. What area we are talking about? If we start from 0, this is area, this is first area, this is second area. Now this area is suppose your third area and this area is suppose your fourth area. We need not to consider this area because they have asked only up to fifth point. So now adding this area, total area will be equals to displacement. That is equals to first area, area of this triangle, half base into height plus area of that rectangle, that is 1 cross 1. Now area of this from 2 to 3 is actually trapezium. So for this trapezium, how to calculate area? Half sum of parallel side means this is 1 and this is 4. So we'll write 1 plus 4. Multiply by distance between them, that is nothing but 1. Next area is also kind of trapezium, that is half sum of parallel side, that is 4 and that is 2. So we write 4 plus 2 multiply by distance between them, that is 2. So this part we have to calculate to find displacement. So first part is nothing but 0.5 plus second is 1 plus next is 4 plus 1 is 5 by 2 is 2.5 plus the last one is 2 will get cancelled, 4 plus 2 is 6. So from here we are getting 2.5 and 0.5 is 3, 1 plus 6, that is 10. So our answer is 10 meter. The displacement which we have calculated is equals to 10 meter.